All right. Models created from photogrammetry are usually dense, and they have a lot of geometry. And that doesn't matter that much inside Blender and Cycles, but it can cause problems with the USDZ rendering. So we'll walk through a useful remeshing and rebaking workflow that solves this for cases like rooms. And we'll start with a charterhouse model as originally downloaded from Sketchfab. So from our Statistics tab in Viewport Overlays, Statistics, we can see that it has about 1.8 million polygons, but most of it is flat planes like walls. And if you look at the mesh by pressing Z and picking wireframe, it looks like we could decimate it, but trying this with Blender's remesher modifier makes Blender bog to a halt. There is a great free remeshing program called Instant Meshes, and I'll put the link below. So we'll try that first. So we're going to first make sure that we've applied all the transforms to our geometry. So we're going to highlight our object and our node hierarchy, hit Control A, and apply all transforms. And that makes sure that the OBJ that we import and export has the same transforms that lines up correctly with the one that we're going to regenerate. All right, so now this has a scale 1, transform 0, etc. So now we'll highlight the OBJ2, then we can do File, Export, and Wavefront OBJ. We're going to pick Z as our up axis, Y as our forward axis, then we'll save it as greatchamber.obj. And then we can go to Instant Meshes and click Open Mesh, OBJ, and open that. It'll take a second to load. Click and drag to rotate, shift and click and drag to translate. So in Instant Meshes, you typically try clicking Solve, and we'll basically get a big mess. These lines should be going straight forward and straight backward. And why is this? What's going on? It turns out that our model has a lot of cracks, vertices and edges that are close but don't align, and that confuses the remesher. So go back to Blender, and we're going to highlight the object, hit Shift D to duplicate, set our translation to 0. We'll hide our original object. And then we're going to hit Tab to go to Edit Mode, A to highlight all polygons in the model. Then we'll pick Mesh, Clean Up, and we're going to Merge by Distance. And we'll pick 1 centimeter for the merge distance, as this is a pretty large room. And then Tab out of Exit Mode. Then once again, we can export Wavefront. We're going to use Selected Only at this point. And once again, we will use our up axis is Z, forward axis Y, and we can just resave it as Gray Chamber. Back into Instant Meshes, Open Mesh, Pay. Once again, we'll click Solve. And there we go. Now we're seeing even lines across the floor. These are the guidelines that Instant Meshes projects on the mesh to show you how it's going to remesh something. So these should go along the length of the floor and be in line with the walls, and in generally in line with features in the wall. You'll see that the features on the ceiling are aligning somewhat with the displacements in the ceiling. And that's great. That's what we want. Now, we'll notice that by default, Instant Meshes sometimes does a fairly extreme polygon reduction that can lose a lot of detail. So I'm going to increase the targeted mesh count to about 160K, 150K. And it'll give us a little bit of a warning. We'll hit yes. And once again, we'll click solve. We have our nice mesh overlay. And then we'll click the position field solve, and we can see how it's going to resolve the position of most of the vertices. That looks good. Go to export mesh, go to extract mesh. And that's the mesh that we're going to get, which is much, much cleaner looking. Now we'll do save, create chamber meshed, and back into Blender. So back in Blender, we'll make a new collection called Bake Geometry. I've already created it here. We'll do a file import. Wavefront, and we're going to pick our remeshed object. And you can see that it lines up very closely with the original object, which is what we want. Now we're going to UV the new model. So we'll go to the UV editing workspace. We'll hide the old object. And if you're not in edit mode, select the new one, select the new object. Tab for edit mode, A for all, U for unwrap, smart UV project, and defaults are okay. Great. And tab out of edit mode. Now we're going to bake the object, and we're going to use the Bake Lab 2 add-on for Blender, and the link is below. You can download the GitHub zip file directly from the webpage under code download zip. We'll turn the visibility of our original back on, and we're going to click on the original, control click on the target, and then hit N for Bake Lab. We're going to do Bake Selected to Active. Our selected is Object 2. our active is Great Chamber Remeshed. Here we're going to press plus, and we're going to add an emission map, and we can make it a 2K map. Click OK. The samples should be fine. Now we'll hit click bake, and we can see over here, here's our newly generated baked map. All right, so we're going to hide our original, and we'll notice we're in material preview that this is still gray. That's because there's no material hooked to it. So we can go over to our shading workspace, and we still have our remesh object picked. We can see there's no material attached to it. I'm going to press new, and we get a principal BSDF. Highlight the principal BSDF, control T to add in a texture and a UV map. And then we're going to scroll down and pick our newly baked image file. Now this still looks a little funny, looks a little washed out. And that is because right now that it's connected to the base color, I'm going to reconnect that to the emission. Click on our base color, dial that down to black. Going to increase our roughness to 1 and decrease our specular to 0. And now we're back to it looking very close to the original. And the textures aren't quite as perfect as in the original heavy scan, but they're fine for real-time previewing. So now we'll export the original and the remeshed room as USDZ to see how much we shrank our USDZ file. First of all, we'll deselect our baked geometry file and show our original object and file, export, USD. And we'll just do Great Chamber USDZ. Scroll down and set our jet set settings as usual. And we're just going to keep our existing texture size. We want to understand how big it was original. So we'll export that. And now we'll turn off that collection, turn on our baked geometry collection. File, export USD. Now we'll remesh. Once again, we'll keep our USDZ textures, because we're going to use the rebaked 2K size. So we'll export a USDZ file pretty quick. So let's check out exactly how these file sizes compare. So the original one was 135.6 megs, and the revised one was 17.5 megs. So that's a pretty big improvement for being able to have the same look on the phone. All right, that about does it.